Hi there. Today on Typical Books, we're going to be talking about some new horror fiction for June of 2021, books that have already come out and books that are about to come out from Horror Writers Association authors. Now, of course, this is something that I do every month or so. I like to do it more often than that so that there's not as many books per list, but of course, it's been almost an entire month, so there's quite a few books to get through. And of course, I did attend the Horror Writers Association Bram Stoker Awards and StokerCon online this year. I'm not going to do a whole recap of that. Suffice it to say that Stephen Graham Jones walked away with a couple very well-deserved awards. We got to hear a song from Josh Malerman. The whole convention was great, as a matter of fact, and I really have to hand it to the organizers of StokerCon, the chair that organizes that portion of the show, and the Final Frame Film Awards, and of course the Anne Radcliffe speeches. Like, all of those things together is what made up StokerCon, and it felt like a convention, even though it was all on like Zoom type things and like video group chats and stuff like that. The chat rooms were very active. It was so fun to participate, especially in panels that were really near and dear to my heart, and maybe yours too if you're watching this video, with panels on cover design and marketing and things like of that nature for horror authors. There's a lot about the business of horror that I basically sat back and just watched, but there was that very welcoming, camaraderie kind of feel that people get from an association like the HWA, but at a convention sometimes you kind of play wallflower, or at least I do. I was compelled to participate and I love that. I can't wait to attend in person, really, honestly. And when it's on the East Coast, it's so tempting, so someday soon. But congratulations to everyone that ended up on the long list, the short list, and all the winners of Bram Stoker Awards, and holy hello to everyone that attended StokerCon. And I saw a lot of familiar faces, other authors I know, other Canadian authors I know, booktubers, and book reviewers, so it was super cool to see that little family of the community there alongside all these great big names. I just adore Steve Razanik-Tem, and he was on a lot of panels, so it was super active. It was so nice to see Brian Keene on panels. Like, it was a very good StokerCon all around. The award ceremony is up on their YouTube channel. I will put a link to it so you can check it out yourself if you missed it, or if you didn't know that such a thing existed. I've known about the Bram Stoker Awards since I was a kid because a lot of my favorite books, my mom and grandmother's favorite books, had Bram Stoker Award winner across the top, so I was very aware. But I meet horror authors that don't know that the Stokies exist. But yeah, so we made a weekend of it. It was super fun. I gave up a lot of my weekend time. That's why I pre-recorded a whole bunch of videos last week. So yeah, that worked out well for me. I definitely made a weekend of the Bram Stoker Awards this year. And even more so because all of the convention to do was online instead of capturing some of the live streamed events after when they're placed on YouTube, if they're ever placed on YouTube. So you may be able to catch a whole bunch of these conference talks and panels on YouTube yourself. Who knows? We'll keep an eye out for it, right? Without further ado, here are some books that are out or coming out from Horror Writers Association authors. It's kind of a big list, and I'm going to start from the bottom up with things that are already out right now. This one's been out for a while, since February, and I read the title, and then I looked at the cover, and then I read the description, and I thought, is this really the same book? It's gotta be. Polygon 29 by Catt Colborn. Mary Shelley has arisen from her unearthly slumber to assist her supernatural sisters in quelling the haunted manor and assisting her newest ward, Jane. Jane's chores are also to eventually help in building another life for her aunt's companionship. Unfortunately, Jane takes up the family axe instead. So you can see why I wasn't sure how the cover had something to do with that. I don't know. Maybe I'm confused. We'll find out. The Vampire's Witch by Damian Serbu. This comes from NineStar Press and it's out already. Jarrett Backman's life spins out of control as he fights human and ghostly enemies. Against the curse of being a witch and the discovery of a secret coven of vampires, can he save himself before utter despair ruins him? We don't know. And this cover caught my eye. It strikes me as something like, we had just reviewed Open 24 Hours on Dead Air, and the cover reminds me of that, and it reminds me of a lot of these like 90s teen horror cycle movies. Faces of Evil by E.L. Jefferson. and this is out already. This work is an anthology that depicts the depth and breadth of human cruelty. Evil will lie in wait, scheming and manipulating the perfect opportunity to attack its chosen prey, you. I don't have the gravity to deliver that with such bravado. The Mother Wound by Jess Landry. This comes from Independent Legions Publishing, and it is out already. Jess Landry blurs the line between genres in her debut collection, magnifying the darkness in the spaces between and confronting those relationships that are nearest and dearest to us in the most horrific ways. Sometimes the deepest wounds are from those we hold the closest, because they can stab you so much easier. And this one reminded me of John over at Books of Blood. Sunshine and the Full Moon by Jon Robinson. This comes from Koehler Books. A werewolf attack and missing girl. To put the pieces of the town's haunting past together, Sunshine Robbins must fight her way through bouts of anxiety and fear as she stares down the devilish beast looking to destroy Dathanville one victim at a time. And more books that are already out. Take Your Turn, Teddy. I love the cover of this book. This comes from Haley Newlin from New Degree Press, and these are a lot of small presses that I'm not familiar with. Independent Legion somewhat, but most of the ones that I've named, and there's quite a few coming up, I haven't heard of these. Teddy, a young boy learning of humanity's monsters, unveils an unworldly evil, one he calls the Shadow. How far will he go? How twisted can he become before every bit of the sweet boy he once was is entombed by murder? Petrified Women by Jeremy Ray. This is another cover I really dig. Infinite Ray Publishing, and this one comes with a bunch of warnings that I'm not going to read as part of the synopsis, but there were a whole bunch of content warnings. Harley has the perfect boyfriend. She finally picked a keeper with Aiden. She hides in his apartment, excitedly waiting to pull off the scare of a lifetime. But then he comes home and Harley witnesses a different side of her boyfriend. Some pranks go too far and this one could be deadly. It sounds kind of light, and then there's a bunch of content warnings. I suspect the boyfriend's up to something, right? Apparently it takes place around Halloween, from what I understand too, so that hence the prank. Now You Will Be Consumed by Nikolas P. Robinson. This comes from Madness Hearts Press and is out already. While investigating a series of peculiar and unsettling deaths in Denver, two deeply flawed detectives learn there may be no salvation for anyone. As the line separating nightmare and reality blurs, the detectives question whether they're capable of solving the mysteries surrounding them before being consumed by inhuman creatures. That sounds somewhat familiar. Now this will sound equally familiar. Zen in the Art of Slaying Vampires. This is the 25th anniversary author revised edition. It has a foreword by Nancy Holder, and this is from the author of Buffy the Vampire Slayer, among a whole bunch of other things. Steven-Elliot Altman, and this comes from WordFire Press, and is out this week. One man rises in a Soho alleyway to find his lover dead and his own body terribly transformed. He strains to overcome his murderous instincts through Zen meditation and blood deprivation. Reclaimed by the ministry, an underground society waging war on the undead, he must master himself and his hunger and the way of the wooden stake. Got some nice Slayer stuff going on there if you're a fan. I know I am. I love this cover, but I will note this must be a cover destined for Kindle only because there is no author name on the cover of this book, which is odd. The Maker's Box by David Barclay. This comes from Aphotic Realm and is out next week. And now that I think of it, maybe it is just a cover for the promotional purposes. Don't know. On the night of her 16th birthday, Emily's father gives her a box with a beating human heart. It's a strange and wondrous piece of magic, unlike anything in her collection. It speaks to her in dreams, promising her the world, if only she'll feed it. So, the cover grabs me, and that description is quite magical, quite poetic, and I'm very interested in this kind of almost a Poe feeling to it, isn't there? Maybe some Dybbuk box stuff going on? I don't know. And this is a poetry collection. I'm not a huge fan of poetry, but I love this cover. And who knows, maybe there's huge fans here. Lost Letters to a Lover's Carcass. Ronald J. Murray, and this comes from Journalstone and is out soon. Ronald J. Murray's second dark poetry collection is a diatribe hurled against abusers, an act of war against those that thrive on the suffering of others. It is a personal look at the process of a man rediscovering his self-worth once defined by an iron fist control of another, once wrongly trusted. It is the escape from horrors designed by miserable creatures to keep you on their level towards self-appreciation and the true appreciation of those that matter. I love that cover, and it reminds me of their very recent Bram Stoker Award finalist Jessica McHugh's poetry collection cover as well. So if you're looking for a collection that looks cool on your shelf, pick both of those up. And finally, Master of Rods and Strings. It's out soon from Jason Mark Harris and published by Vernacular Books. I do love this cover. It reminds me of like old crime noir or something. Jealous of the attention lavished upon the puppetry talents of his dear sister and tormented by visions of her torture at the hands of his mysterious Uncle Pavin, who recruited her for his arcane school, Elias is determined to learn the true nature of occult puppetry, no matter the hideous costs, in order to exact vengeance. So we're ending on a high note there with two books that have like occult, dark fantasy horror things going on that I'm very interested in, and a lot of really cool artwork as usual. If there's anything on that list that you've already read or that you're going to pick up, definitely let me know in the comments. And of course, if you attended the Horror Writers Association Bram Stoker Awards or StokerCon, definitely say hello. Thank you very much for watching, and have an ooky, spooky day.